Apollo 11 is now going out of the passive thermal control mode in which it was slowly rotating to maintain thermal balance. It's getting set up for the P-23 activities. That's the mid-course navigation. Capcom Bruce McCandless is passing up some changes in the procedures for this navigational operation.
Houston, Apollo 11.
Go ahead, 11.
Okay, we're stopping PTC now and maneuvering to our P-52 and optics Cal attitude. In regard to the P-23, what I was trying to tell you yesterday was about that. The M line is not anywhere parallel to the horizon at the roll, pitch, and yaw, which you give me to go to for the substellar point, and I was trying to maneuver off to get it parallel to the horizon when y'all said that was not necessary.
Roger, 11. I guess in keeping the cups of coffee score, why, you get that one.
Well, okay, well, this morning let's just see how close it comes to being parallel to the M line before we start marking the first time. It appeared that the computation of those three angles was somewhat off, and that I was wasting a lot of gas by going to those three angles and then having to make large attitude changes after that to get the M line parallel. And in some cases it appeared to be just an excessive attitude required, and y'all said it wasn't needed, so I was marking in some cases with the M line not parallel. I thought perhaps you had some processor for computing that offset and making sense out of that data, but as far as I know, we've got to have the M line parallel to the horizon.
Roger, 11. We don't have that capability. We do require that the M line be parallel to the horizon in order to get a good mark. We feel that possibly the state vector information that you were using for your maneuver basis yesterday may have needed to be updated a little, and if you'll stand by a second, we'll give you an evaluation of what we feel you'll get today by the auto maneuver.
Okay. Thank you.
Apollo 11, over.
Go ahead, 11.
Roger, I'm getting ready to do an O2 fuel cell purge. Do you have any particulars on this? And I assume you want these one at a time, or can I triple up, over?
We'd like them one at a time, and stand by. I don't think we have any sequence. You can do them in any order you want.
That's okay.
And we're watching you on TM down here.
We wanted to...
Apollo 11, you want to look at these NAN 93s before I proceed on them?
Yes, please. Stand by a second.
Okay.
11, this is Houston. On our TM here, we're only seeing values in two registers. Can you read us out the contents of register 3, please?
Register 3 minus 3 balls, 2, 4.
Roger, minus 3 balls, 2, 4, and you can go ahead and proceed.
Okay, proceeding at this time.
Houston, after you've completed P-52, we'd like to uplink you a new state vector so we start out clean on this P-23. Over.
Okay.
Houston, you observing the higher O2 flow on fuel cell 3? Houston, Apollo 11, it's triggered the master alarm 3 times now. The there goes number 4. It goes up to about 1.4 and oscillates back down to about 1.1. Over.
Roger, we're showing 1.3 now on TM. Stand by a second.
And we're in Poo now for a state vector.
Roger, give us accept, please.
Roger that.
Houston, on your O2 flow fuel cell 3, apparently it was flowing a little higher than the other two during purge, but the flow rate's acceptable. Over.
Roger, understand. It seems to be flowing a little bit more and actually putting out more current than the other two also. Over.
All right, you would copy. This is Houston. We've completed the uplink. The computer is yours. You can go back to block.
Okay, thank you.
Go ahead, 11.
Houston 11, I don't believe we were calling you right now.
Roger out.
This is Apollo Control at 24 hours, 22 minutes into the mission. Apollo 11's distance from the Earth is 102,436 nautical miles, velocity 5,288 feet per second.
This is Houston, go ahead.
Roger, I'm in a good attitude here to do, I have in the sextant this last P-52 star. What number? Star 37, is that all right for the optics calibration to save some gas, or do you want to go over to star 40?
Star 37 will be fine for the optics calibration. And we haven't noticed a verb 66 yet after our state vector uplink, over.
Okay.
When you move on into P23, we recommend that you use the CMC computed angles for your auto maneuver and see how that works out. If it doesn't bring you up with the M line parallel to the horizon at the substellar point, we'll see if we can get you some ground computed angles. I guess the big thing here is to make sure that the M line is parallel at the substellar point so we get a good angular measurement, over.
Yeah, I believe.
Roger, roger.
Star 37 is Nunki, N-U-N-K-I. Apollo 11 is on program 52, which is realignment of the platform prior to beginning the cislunar navigation operation.
Yes, an Apollo 11 marking on this star. I got a NAN 87 twice in a row of five balls, so that's sufficient for a Cal.
That's certainly very sufficient.
Okay. So now I'm going to go to Pooh, and I'm going to take your three angles and do a VERB 49 maneuver to your substellar point, okay?
Okay, we recommend that for the first star, since we gave you a new state vector, we'd like to try the CMC computed angles for the auto maneuver.
Okay.
And if you hit proceed on this display to enter the zero.
Not yet.
Okay. Houston, over the past 2 hours, we've seen a slight continuing increase in partial pressure CO2. Have you, in fact, changed the CO2 canister yet this morning? We don't need to do it right now. We'd just like to confirm that our instrumentation is in good shape. Over.
No, we haven't changed any canister this morning.
Okay. Then I guess we can plan on accomplishing that after P23 is over and you got the LAB clear.
All right.
Apollo 11, we're in the process of maneuvering to P23's desired attitude. It likes roll 8.37, pitch 61.33, and yaw 339.87. Over.
Roger, we copy. And that's for star 01.
Star 01, Earth near horizon, code 110.
Roger.
Houston, Apollo 11. On this star, the auto maneuver worked just fine. I'm right at the substellar point. Everything looks beautiful, except there's no star in sight. It's just not visible.
Roger, this is for star 01.
That's correct.
You're not getting any reflections or anything like that that would obscure your vision, are you?
Well, of course, the Earth is pretty bright in the black sky. Instead of being black, has sort of a rosy glow to it. And the star, unless it's a very bright one, it's probably lost somewhere in that glow, but it's just not visible. I've maneuvered the reticle considerably above the horizon to make sure that the star is not lost in the brightness below the horizon. However, even when I get the reticle considerably above the horizon so that the star should be seen against a black background, it still is not visible.
Roger, we copy. Stand by a minute, please. This is Houston. Can you read us the shaft and trunnion angle off the counters?
Yeah, I'd be glad to. Shaft 331.2 and trunnion 35.85.
Roger, thank you.
It's really a fantastic sight through that section. A minute ago during that auto maneuver, the reticle swept across the Mediterranean. You could see all of North Africa, absolutely clear, all of Portugal, Spain, southern France, all of Italy, absolutely clear. It was just a beautiful sight.
Roger, we all envy you the view up there.
But still no star.
11, this is Houston, over.
Go ahead, Bruce.
Roger. On our ground computers, we confirm the shaft and trunnion angle that you have as being pointed at the star. However, it looks as though that shaft and trunnion angle is also pointing into the structure of the limb, so that while you would be getting the Earth horizon, the star LOS is obscured by the limb. We recommend an auto maneuver to the attitudes and the pen and ink into the flight plan. Roll 177.2, pitch 298.2, and yaw 330.0. Over.
Okay, fine. Let's try that.
11, this is Houston. While you're maneuvering here, can we get a LEM CM Delta P reading from you? Over.
Right, just a tad under one, Bruce. 0.95.
Roger, 0.95.
This Apollo Control, that reading was the difference in pressure between the lunar module cabin and the command module cabin. Thank you.
Apollo 11, Houston.
Go ahead.
Is the commander aboard?
This is Jim Lovell calling with Apollo 11.
Roger, the commander aboard.
I was a little worried. This is the backup commander still standing by. You haven't given me the word yet. How you go?
You've lost your chance to take this one, Jim.
Okay, I concede.
Houston, Apollo 11.
Go ahead, 11.
Okay, our maneuver is complete, and at this attitude, the M-line is exactly 90 degrees out of phase. It is exactly pointed along the vector toward the center of the Earth instead of being parallel to the horizon.
Roger.
I'm going to hold right here for your next suggestion.
Roger. Thank you.
Okay, Houston, it appears to be okay now. We've changed our attitude slightly, and I have the star, and I'm maneuvering to get the M-line parallel.
This is Houston. Roger, we copy.
This is Apollo Control at 25 hours, 20 minutes. Apollo, I'll let...
And you... Our standby one.
Distance is now 103,263 nautical miles, velocity 5,256 feet per second. This Apollo Control, belay that last announcement. Those figures are not based on the proper ground elapsed time. This display is static. We don't have the present numbers.
Houston Apollo 11, are you copying these noun 49s? We've been going through them fairly swiftly.
Yes, we certainly are. I see a plus 0.1 and a plus 0.2 on nautical miles and feet per second. Over.
Right.
11, this is Houston, over. Yeah, Mike, we show you in verb 59 right now, over.
That's right, I haven't entered, I gave it back to the computer for a second. I put the mode switch from manual back to CMC while I flew over the disky, and the computer drove the star off out of sight. So the delay here has been in going back to manual and finding the star again, which I've finally done, and in just a second here I'll go to enter and get a 51 and mark on it. So as I say, for some reason the computer drove the star off out of sight.
Okay, roger out. Thank you. Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Go ahead.
Roger, we show you with a little less than an hour or two, the mid-course correction number two burn. We recommend that you terminate the P23 activities here and press on with a wastewater dump, which we need from you, and getting ready for the burn, over.
Okay.
And I have your mid-course correction number two pad here when you're ready to copy. This is Houston, mid-course correction number two, SPS GNN, 63059er, plus 097, minus 020, GET ignition, 026445792, plus 00118 minus 00003 plus 00177 roll 277355015 noun 44 block is NA Delta VT 00 213-003-00168 Section Star 302082-370 The rest of the pad is NA GDC Align, Vega and Deneb Roll Align 007-144-068 No ullage. Lem weight 33302. And for your information, your heads will be pointed roughly towards the earth in this burn. Read back over.
Roger, make course correction number two, SPS GNN 63059er plus 097. Minus 020-026-445792 plus 00118 minus 00003 plus 00177-277. You're
still copying, over. Roger, still copying, go ahead. Apollo 11, this is Houston. I copied your transmission about roll 277, and go ahead from roll 277, over.
Roger. 355015 NA 00213-003-00168-302082. 370 Vega and Deneb 007-144-068 No ullage Lem weight 33302 Head toward the earth, over
11, this is Houston Read back correct, out Apollo 11 Houston, over. Roger, we'd like you to terminate battery A charge at GET 26 hours and reinitiate battery A charge after mid-course correction 2. Over.
Apollo 11, roger.
Roger out.
This is Apollo Control at 25 hours, 58 minutes. Apollo 11's distance is now 107,224 nautical miles. Velocity 5,106 feet per second.
This is Houston, over.
Go ahead.
Roger. If you can give us accept, we'll send you up a state vector and a target load for the maneuver.
Okay, give us 1 minute to check the B-23 damage.
Sure thing.
Houston, Apollo 11, the disc is yours.
Houston, roger that.
This is Apollo Control at 26 hours. The ignition time for this mid-course correction will be 26 hours, 44 minutes, 57 seconds, about 44 minutes from now. It will be a service propulsion system maneuver. Duration of the burn will be 3 seconds. The delta V, 21.3 feet per second. This mid-course maneuver should reduce the paracentian of Apollo 11's trajectory from the present 175 nautical miles to 60 nautical miles.
11, this is Houston. We've completed the uplink. The computer is yours.
Thank you.
Houston, Apollo 11.
Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Roger, I wonder if you have a star that might be a little closer to the direction we're burning than the one you gave
us. Roger, we're going to rework the attitude and the sextant star for you in order to improve the high gain antenna coverage, and we'll have that for you in a few seconds.
Maybe I can make it just a change in roll.
Roger. This is Houston, over. Ahead. Roger. On your attitude for the burn, we'd like you to use roll 096, pitch 356, yaw 018, and that will give you a section star of 01, shaft 253.8, trunnion 24.2. Over. Houston, I'm having difficulty reading you through the noise. Could you read back again, please? Over. Roger, very weakly in the noise, but I think I can copy. Go ahead.
Okay, roll 096.
356, 018, star 01, 586. Roger, I got all of that except trunnion. If trunnion 242, over.
Houston, Apollo 11, how do you read on Omni 8?
Roger, loud and clear, 11.
Okay, we'll stay on Omni 8 for a while.
Okay, I got all your readback except the value for trunnion, and if it's 242, confirm, please.
Roger, 242.
Okay.
The guidance officer reports Apollo 11 is now in the attitude for the mid-course correction. This is Apollo Control at 26 hours, 27 minutes. Apollo 11's distance from Earth now 108,594 nautical miles. Velocity 5,057 feet per second. We're about 17 and a half minutes away from the mid-course correction.
Thank you.
Houston Apollo 11, could you give us a couple of high gain antenna angles, please?
Roger, stand by 11. Roger, 11, pitch minus 35, yaw 0, over.
Thank you.
Okay.
Houston Apollo 11, are you in high gain?
I read you loud and clear on the high gain down here, and everything's looking good from our standpoint for your burn, over.
Okay, Bruce.
This is Apollo Control at 26 hours, 40 minutes. We're just under 4 minutes to the mid-course correction maneuver. Apollo 11's distance from the Earth is 109,245 nautical miles. Its velocity is 5,033 feet per second. Spacecraft weight, 96,361 pounds. 1 minute to the burn. Duration will be 3 seconds. Burning. Shut down.
Burn complete. Are you copying our residuals?
Affirmative. Houston, on our real-time telemetry, we saw 95 to 97 PSI on chamber pressure. We will look at the recordings down here, though, and get back with you again, over.
Okay, thank you.
And we've copied your residuals, 11.
Roger.
Yeah, we're not going to trim those residuals.
This is Apollo Control. That was a good burn. The residuals were in the order of a half a foot a second or less, and will not be trimmed. We're showing spacecraft weight now is 96,159 pounds.
11 Houston, could we get your Delta V counter reading, please, from this burn?
Minus 3.8.
Minus 2.8?
3.8.
Roger, copy, minus 3.8.
Houston, is there anything else you need on the burn status report?
This is Houston, negative 11.
Roger, thank you.
Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Alright, Houston, Apollo 11.
Roger. Just want to remind you, we haven't noticed on our TM the VERP 66 after the burn. And for your information, we played the recorded TV back last night, I believe, after you all turned in for your rest period, and the pictures came out quite well. Over.
Did you get any usable pictures out of Mila on that first pass?
Not that we've seen. We had word on the voice loop that Mila reported that they had gotten a minute worth of a TV signal, and Goldstone reported that they had gotten about a minute's worth of modulation, but that they weren't able to get anything off of it.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, we have another input here, 11, that the Mila data was recognizable as a picture, but we don't have any evaluation as to the quality of the picture. Over.
Okay.
And for our information, we've been watching a PCO2 again. Did you change a lithium hydroxide canister this morning? Over.
Yes, we did, and we've been seeing 1.7% in the spacecraft ever since.
Roger, that agrees with our data.
1.7 millimeters.
Roger, we copy.
Apollo 11, we're starting our maneuver to
Houston, over.
Go ahead.
Roger, from a propellant balancing standpoint, we recommend that you use quads Alpha and Bravo to start the PTC maneuvers. Over.
Roger, understand Alpha and Bravo.
Roger out.